Welcome to week number 9. Man, can you believe it? We're already at week number 9 of our distance digital learning PE, and you guys are doing fantastic. I can tell, and I'm so encouraged. I cannot say enough how great I think my kinders and first and second graders are doing just by the comments that you leave, by how many of you are doing the workouts, how many of you are popping on and doing these things, and you are going to be so ready for when we come back together. You're going to be way beyond all the other grades because you guys are amazing. So anyway, I want to take the time to get ready for our learning right now. So I'm going to move this down just a little bit, move this down just a hair. I'm going to get ready. Remember, for today's workout, you're going to need a ball. So if you don't have some type of ball, I've got like a little foam ball here. I got a sock ball. I'll zoom in on these. A little sock ball, just something made out of just socks right there. Kind of get out of the way. So just kind of roll them up. Or a tape ball, all right? It's about 4 pieces of paper rolled up, and then I've got tape wrapped around them, about in the shape of a ball. So about 4 pieces of paper wrapped up, about the size of a tennis ball, baseball, softball, whichever works. But you're gonna need one of those. So if you don't have one, go ahead and pause it and go get one, all right? But if you are ready, let's get ready. I'm gonna get ready. If you've got your water, and I set my towel over there. But I am ready to work out. Like I said, promise you guys, we're gonna have a new workout. We got done with our HIIT workouts. You guys did amazing on those HIIT workouts, and remembering what they are and what type, and giving you had some great explanations of those HIIT workouts. I think David, you gave me a great one. Micah, you guys just totally are getting this, totally understanding. Micah, your dribbling skills are awesome. And Isabella, I told you, or you asked me to give some shout outs, so I'm trying to do that, trying to remember to do that. We are ready. So our workout this week, or for the next few weeks, is gonna be what's called a body weight workout. So a lot of people use weights. Your parents might have some, they lift weights or dumbbells or barbells or whatever. But a lot of people can't afford those. I don't expect you guys to go out and buy weights. But what the weight that we do have is the weight that we carry around on our body every day. So we're already kind of used to that. So now we're going to use those type of workouts. We're going to introduce some type of workouts that utilizes the weight that we have to strengthen our muscles. And so these are going to be similar to a HIIT workout, but a little bit different. You'll notice some similarities, but some of you will be like, oh, that's totally different. So a body weight workout. That means also that we've got a new warm-up coming up. And so anyway, I want to get right into it. Our caring habit of the week is trusting, okay? So that means that you can trust others. If they say something, you're gonna trust them. If you wanna believe them, okay? You're gonna trust them. Also, it means that you can be trustworthy. If you say something, that means if you say yes, it's gonna be yes. If you say no, it's gonna be no. We're not gonna be changing our mind all the time and waffling, So we're going to be very trusting and trustworthy. So that's our caring habit of the week. Think of ways that you can use that or show that. So but let's get into it. So I'm gonna go over for our warm-up, I'm gonna go over the exercises, and then after a warm-up, I'm gonna go over the different types of exercises for our bodyweight workout. So essentially, our first warm-up, and we're just gonna do these for about 30 seconds, and we'll go right into the next one. Our first one is called a good morning, and it's very simple. You just kind of bend down, and you go like this, good morning! You don't have to shout it like I do. Good morning. You don't have to do that. You don't have to shout it, but that's it. Just simply just squat down and go up. All right. So that's good morning. And then our squat reach. Okay. And I'm gonna do this. So our squat reach, we go down and we come up and we turn and we put our palms up and then we come in and then we turn in the other way. So nice and easy. This is a warm up. It's not a HIIT workout. So we're not going super fast. That's our squat reach. And then of course, jumping jacks. Regina, I got you, sister. You've been asking for more jumping jacks, so our warm-ups are going to include 30 seconds of jumping jacks. Not fast, not HIIT workout type jumping jacks. Nice, slice and slow. So really gives you an opportunity to work on your form. If you're still having a little bit of trouble getting a nice big X, okay, and we're not coming down, this by doing it slow gives us a good opportunity to do that. So I'm going to set my timer here, 30 seconds. It'll be about a 5-second pause. Between each one, remember, it's just a warm-up, gets our blood flowing, and so not a HIIT workout. All right, so let me turn up our timer. Oop, I stopped it. So, like I said, our first one is good morning. So a little bit wider athletic stance. Down, up, down. Nice big breath. In through the nose, out through the mouth. This kind of gets us prepared for a bodyweight workout. Okay, that was 30 seconds. Now we're gonna do our squat reach. So remember, we're gonna squat, down, turn, down, turn, okay? Down, turn. Good job, you guys. While we're doing this, I want you to think about ways that you can show that caring habit of the week. Trusting, okay? A great one, all right? Maybe you have to practice with your brother or sister, okay? But you guys can do that. Okay, and our last one, slow jumping jacks. Here we go. And X, X breathing, X. I had a great time this week. I got to see Declan, and I went to see him at his birthday. And so he showed me a medal. He's doing a virtual, he did a virtual Scooby-Doo 5K. And I want to encourage you guys, talk to your parents, see if maybe you can do a virtual 5K. It's very easy. You can jog it, you can walk it, you can run it. But that's our warm-up. I want to show you, this is my medal, and I don't have the shirt that I got. I'm kind of worn out. But about 5-6 years ago, of the very first virtual run that I did. This is my first virtual. I did a 10K, but there are so many virtual 5Ks out there that you guys can do. I want to encourage you to look those up, train for one of those, work with your parents. I was very proud of Declan. He had a cool Scooby-Doo medal, and it came with a shirt, and so things like that. But you can look those up. I'm going to be doing a couple. I think I'm going to do a Batman 5K, and maybe even an adventure is out there. The movie Up, 10K coming up. So anyway, I want to just throw that out there. So we're gonna get right to our body weight workouts. And on this one, I'm gonna show you what they are. I'm gonna move my, I have to move this down so you can see me a little bit better. All right, so because this one, and remember, the form, having the right form, I'd rather you do it nice and slow than trying to speed through it and then not having the correct form, okay? So correct form means having the right body position. Looking right. So we're gonna do our shoulder taps, and those are just like we did, okay? So nice straight from our head all the way down to our ankles, feet together, and we're just gonna reach out and tap our shoulders. Going like this, so nice and straight, tap, tap. And we're gonna do that for 20 seconds, and then we're gonna do what's called a 2-minute active recovery. So this is kind of the cool down, but it's a recovery exercise that we're gonna do during that. And that active recovery is an overhead reach. And so for that one, I guess I gotta change this. Sorry, boys and girls. So for that one, we kind of squat down, and we reach over and get a nice stretch over here. Eat, and the whole time, we're trying to tighten our muscle, our ab muscles, our abdominals, our core muscles. Go down, up, down, trying to tighten those muscles as we go down and up. So that's our overhead reach. And then next one is squat jumps. And again, our glute goes back, and we go down and up. Simple. Down, we squat down, and we jump up. Squat jumps, very simple. You guys got this one. And then for our actual recovery on that one, it's just what you guys know these as glute kickers. Some people call them butt kickers, but we don't call them that in my class. We call them glute, because this is our gluteus maximus. And we're just nice and slow. We're just back, kind of getting a nice stretch in our thighs up here, and just active recovery, get our heart rate back down, because our exercise, our body weight exercises, get our heart rate up. So that is our squat, our glute kickers. And then our last one is push-ups. And again, I'm going to go down a little bit down on here, because I really want you guys, there's a couple of ways that if you can do them, okay, second grade, you guys should really be working on doing it this way, where we're nice and straight, and hands are just a little bit wider than our shoulders. We go down, and up. Don't do chicken wings. Come down and up, okay? That's our push-up. Now, some of you are like, Mr. Austin, I'm not strong enough to do push-ups yet. So, you could find a chair or something that's nice and solid, okay? I'm gonna move this, I'm gonna up, I lost those. So, down and up. Now this one's a little wide, I can go down, but I'm doing a chair push-up. You can even do it by leaning into a wall, or this is what I'd like some of you to try and do. You just go right above your knee, okay? Not your kneecap, but right above it. And I'm gonna show you that right here. So we'll go down and we'll go right. I'm not on that kneecap, but I'm just right above it. And now I can do straight body push-ups. Because remember, we don't want the glutey, the mountaintop glutey, we don't want that. We want nice straight, okay? So if you're doing it under, just above your knees, your kneecap, like this, all right? And that way, we don't hurt that kneecap, okay? So, that's our push-ups. And then our recovery is gonna be called a boxer bounce. And that is just kind of like, well, I guess I gotta get my feet back in there. Nice and simple. It's just kind of on your tippy toes, just going side to side like that. Or almost like running in place, but we're not putting our heels on the ground. We're staying on our tippy toes. We're engaging our gastrocnemius, for those of you that remember what that is, okay? So that's gonna be our 2-minute active recovery. And then we'll do a little cool down around the world, we know that, and then walk in place. So I wanna get right to it. Put my, these back, okay? And I'm gonna set the timer. So our first exercise, boys and girls, is going to be our shoulder taps. So let me get the timer set. And I had it. What happened to it? I may have to fix this. I am very sorry, boys and girls. I'm just going to fix it right now. 20 seconds of workout, and then 2 minutes of recovery. Okay? So, shoulder taps. I'm going to move this down, okay, so you can see how we're already there. Okay, nice and easy. Remember, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In our body, we're using our strength of our arms and our core to hold us up and keep us in place. So this is a really good body weight exercise. And we're only doing it for 20 seconds. We're only doing one, not three times, like we did the HIIT workout, okay? But we're gonna do one workout, and then we're going to go into our active recovery, all right? We'll keep our feet together. All right, 20 seconds is almost up. Okay, come on, guys, stay with me. We're almost done. Okay, all right. Sorry about that, boys and girls. I went longer than my 20 seconds. I don't know what happened, it didn't beep. So I'm gonna pause it, and I'm gonna have to restart it. Don't you guys, we're just working your active recovery. So while we're doing that, just remember that slow overhead reach, okay? So work on that, okay? Ready, 2 minutes. Slow overhead reach. Okay, and hopefully my timer doesn't, so it's just down, up. I'll fix this a little bit. Kind of hard to do it, to get all types of exercises. So just down, up, nice and slow. Okay, remember, on the body weight exercise, our heart rate gets kind of high. We want to exercise it back down to where it's not beating as fast, okay? All right, and after this, we're gonna do 20 seconds of squat jumps. But I'm gonna check, make sure when we're doing that, that my timer is right this time. Down, we've got about a minute left of these, see? It feels like a long time compared to the 20 seconds that we've been doing, but just doing squat, reach, okay? And we're also getting a little bit of workout and using our body weight on the squats with the thighs. Okay, you guys are doing fantastic. Come on, keep it up. Breathe in and out. Come on, stay with me, guys. Okay, if you can't and you need to take a break, shake off the legs, you can do that, but then come right back to it. Nice and easy, go as fast or slow. Okay, 30 more seconds, come on. You guys got this. seems like a long time when we do the short HIIT workout, short workouts with not as much rest. But remember those breaks, we didn't do anything. These are an active recovery break. Okay, 10 more seconds. And, all right, let's go ahead and stop. And I'm going to my okay, let's get ready for our squat jumps. 20 seconds, okay? We squat and then jump. And squat, jump, squat. You do like a frog jump, touch the floor and come up. Down, up, down. After this, we're gonna do the glute kickers. Slow glute kickers, remember. That slow warm up, because this one, your heart rate should be getting up. Do it with me, boys and girls. Keep going. And, oh, something's going on with my timer. It's not working the way it should. So let's, my apologies, boys and girls. Okay, slow glute kickers. We're going to touch our heel to our bottom. Okay, can you see that back there? After this, we're going to work on our push-ups. And you can put that foot down flat when you come, not let the box bounce, but we're going to be on our tippy toes or on our toes. Okay, all right. Now some of you, you might be like, this is easy, Mr. Austin. I can do a less exercise, which is great. Some of you are like, Mr. Austin, this is hard. But think about how hard the HIIT workout was and how well you did. Learning a new thing sometimes is hard, but since you guys are who you are, I have total faith in you, total trust in you. Look at that, see what I did? Total trust in you that you can do this and you can do it well, okay? Got about one more minute of this, nice, easy, okay? And again, I know it seems like a long time, but just keep following along, nice, and get your foot up real high. Don't be lazy, don't go like this, but get it up nice and high to where you're trying to touch your heel and you're getting a good stretch in that thigh right up here. Okay, 45 seconds, boys and girls, come on. Stay with me. And then after this, we're gonna do our push-ups, okay? And I will, and then our boxer bounce. So for the push-ups, I'll adjust the camera again. About 30 seconds. Keep going, keep going. Nice, easy. Active recovery, okay? I want you to remember that word, active recovery. It's a rest, but it's not a just standing around doing nothing type of recovery. That's called a passive recovery. This is active, but we're doing an activity. 10 more seconds, boys and girls, okay? Okay, all right, you guys keep going, and let's go. And this is gonna be our push-ups. Oh, man, the timer is just way off. I don't know what. Let's get ready for our push-ups, boys and girls. Remember, if you can do them without touching your knees on the ground, go ahead and do that. If you have to use your knees, go ahead. But I wanna keep straight back, all right? And. All right, come on, boys and girls. About 5 more seconds. One. One more. Come on. All right, there we go. Okay. And let's get ready for our active recovery. I promise, boys and girls, that our next workout, I'll have this fixed. Because it is not working out well right now. Okay. So this one is our boxer bounce, just on our toes, nice and easy. 2 minutes of that, And you could even go forward, go in a circle if you want. But, okay, stay on those toes and just, now this one's gonna work several muscles in your legs. Okay, it's gonna work your calves, the gastrocnemius, you guys remember that one? Your thighs, quadriceps, and other muscles in there. Those are the only ones I remember right now. So, and you have to go fast. Maybe you need to just walk it out. Walk it out. That's okay too. Remember, this is recovery. We want our heart rate to get back down. Okay, and that was our last workout. This is our last workout. We'll do a little cool down, and we're going to go into our catching and throwing. Nice and easy. Got about 1 minute. Okay, boys and girls. If you guys have done some 5Ks already and you got a medal, man, include that in a picture. If you can, show me. Show me what you've done. And then if you're gonna do one, talk to your mom and dad and say, hey, I'd like to do a virtual 5K. And if you need information on that, I will give that out. But if your parents can always just look up virtual 5Ks. And usually part of the money that you spend on it goes to supporting a good cause. So like I think the one that's the Scooby-Doo one that Declan and his mom did, it supported St. Jude's Children's Hospital. So what a great cause. Plus they got some cool stuff from it. So anyway, 4 more seconds. Okay, all right, there we go, boys and girls. So that is our body weight workout. One and done. And after that, I need a little bit of water. Let's get ready for a cool down. 15 seconds around the world one way, 15 seconds around the other, and then our just walk into place. Let's get ready. Okay, ready? And I'm just gonna count these. It'll be about 5 each way. So we squat down, we bring it around, squat down, almost touch the ground. Remember, come all the way up, squat down, don't bend over. Let's squat down, come up. This is number 3, and number 4, and number 5. Let's stop, pause, and go the other way. 1, nice big around the world. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Great job, boys and girls. Okay, now let's get to our walking place. 15 seconds. Swing our arms just a little bit. Remember, our left leg goes up, our right arm does too. Right arm, our right leg, left arm. Okay, you guys can do this. And about 5 more seconds, breathing in and out. Okay, all right, boys and girls. So now, if you need to take a break, you need to pause it, go ahead. I'm feeling pretty good. I'm gonna go right into our exercise. I'm gonna grab a ball. I'm gonna use this ball because I'm going to change the angle of this real quick because I think this is important, okay? I want you to see. So first of all, the first thing we're gonna do on our grip, and I'm gonna check my notes, on our throwing, and we're gonna learn the underhand and overhand throws. Okay, and these are important. They're two different types of throws, very similar motions, but they're to get them right and to get our aim right, we need to go through the steps to learn how to do it properly. And the first thing I want you to do is learn how to grip it. I don't want you to grab your ball like this with all your fingers around it. If you have a bigger ball, you're gonna use about 3 fingers and your pinkies gonna go over there, okay? Okay, and you can spread your finger out across the top or the sides there, but our thumb is gonna be on top, okay? So our thumb, it's kinda hard to show you. Thumb on top right there, and our fingers are on the side. Now, if you have a smaller ball, you can do 2. Okay, see my thumb down there? Okay, what's depending on if I'm throwing it overhand, thumb is on the bottom, underhand, thumb's on top, and 2 fingers. That's just a basic throw. There's other types of grips, but I don't want you to grip it with your whole hand like this, okay? And I don't want you to cup it, okay? We're gonna kind of use our fingers off our side, spread our fingers out, and keep our thumb on top, okay? So that is our grip. So make sure, as you're getting ready to do this, check your grip. Say, okay, Mr. Austin, I've got my ball, I'm ready to throw, my grip looks good. If you're grabbing it like this, or if you've got, trying something weird like that, remember, depending on the size of the ball, So like this is almost a little bit smaller than a softball, but I can still use three fingers. But my pinky is just kind of a guide, my little pinky finger, or he's like a little guide. I don't know if you can see that very good. But anyway, so, all right, so what I want you to practice with, once you got your grip, we're gonna do is called step, swing, throw, or step, swing, toss. And the reason I wanted you to have a softer ball is because if you're doing this inside, like a hard baseball or a hard softball is gonna break something. Also, they're gonna roll around a lot. Okay, they're gonna roll. So if you're just doing this right now, we're not doing it for distance, we're just practicing getting the motions right. And everybody can do this. I want everybody to practice this motion. We're gonna get into the different breakdowns of kindergarten, first, second grade, after we come back from fall break, okay? So it is, I think I need to change my angle here. Sorry, boys and girls. There we go, I think this will be easier. Okay, so good, now I can see my, so on this one, we're gonna step, if you are throwing with your right hand, you're gonna step out with your left, or opposite. If you are throwing with your left hand, you're gonna step out with your right foot, your opposite. So remember, the step is the opposite, okay? Not the same side, okay? So look at that, okay? But I'm gonna step forward, and as I step, I start my swing back. I've got a good grip, and I'm looking at my target. So I step, swing, and then I kind of come forward, and I throw it, okay? And I did a nice toss, and came right back to me because it bounced off the thing. So right? So step, swing, throw. Those are the things that I want you to remember. Those are the things that I want you to practice after this. Okay, step, swing, throw. So step, swing, throw, or toss. Okay, all right. And remember, it works the same if you use a tape ball, you know, now, and or a sock ball, just this one you can see, I only need two fingers. Two fingers, thumb on top, and step, swing, throw, okay? All right, boys and girls, that is what I want you to work out for today. Now, after spring break, if you wanna get a couple more, we're gonna be using targets, so we're gonna be throwing for targets or whatever, but that's after fall break. I said spring break, but after fall break. So if you need to get a couple more tape balls, have three or four, or softballs, I really like those, because you can reuse those. I just use a big pair of ski socks, one pair of ski socks rolled up, gave me a nice size ball. So you can make those pretty easy. If you want it bigger, you just add more socks. So that is our workout for today. As always, boys and girls, I love you. Keep those videos coming. Keep me showing how awesome you are and amazing. And I will try and remember some more names of people that are I'm gonna call out and just encourage them. And on Wednesday, Thursday, it is PE and PJ's day. So we're gonna have a fun time. And so you don't have to wear PJs. I'm going to be wearing mine, but you don't have to if you don't want to. But PE and your PJs. All right, boys and girls, I love you. I will see you later. Bye-bye.